take them out.
In and out. In and out.
Out. In out. Save out. Close again. Push it a bit. Yeah.
Halfway.
Yeah, halfway, and then keep holding this. Keep holding this, and I'll try. Yeah, it's released. So it's
okay.
Good.
So then, right now, I can.
If you want to now, you want to shoot, right?
Yeah.
Polar bear coming.
And then, if I want to shoot.
Yeah. So just open it.
Okay.
And it's ready to shoot.
Okay.
So it's already inside, right?
Okay.
And then after shooting, you open and stuff.
Okay.
我们所有进到北极科学站的人都要学会使用这样的步枪，以防如果有北极熊来的时候，一个可以吓跑北极熊，也是为了我们自己的安全着想。
One bullet, and the bullet it goes to the barrel, okay, and is loaded. Okay, so now I take a shot. So we take a shot to the bullet. Ready?
Oh.
All right.
要真的扣下扳机射出子弹，只有在北极熊攻击人类的时候，但目的也只是想吓跑它，并非真的要置它于死。不过学会使用步枪是所有进驻北极研究站人员的必备技能。
This is polar bear footprint and it's very fresh. You can see actually you see the clothes, but because it was raining yesterday, so if it was not fresh, it would be already washed. So probably last night was Beijing Xiong, a polar bear actually visited, and by that direction they walked. He probably went to our food storage to sniff food.
北极熊现身已经不是第一次了，用铁皮盖成的食物储藏室已经被饿坏的北极熊敲打得凹凸不平。它们的嗅觉敏锐，科学家认为是猎犬的七倍，甚至可闻到一公里远的海豹气味。
因为我们刚刚早上看到了一个北极熊的足迹哦，现在我们科学家要带着这个来福枪到周边去巡视看看，为了安全着想，要确保看看北极熊是不是还在附近。
提高警觉是要确保双方能够和平相处。
它只是很快的让我们知道那个每一个 measurement 的结果，但是基本上浅的在上面，深的在下面，然后左边就是头，右边就是尾巴，然后蓝色的是resistive， 红色的是比较 conductive，
啊 conductive， 是在我们
所以下面都比较 conductive，
对。
中央大学的张并宇教授在北极苔原上利用地电组量测的资料观察地下涌动土的变化。此时天空下着小雨，我们盯着电脑的运算结果，却没注意到远方有个神秘客正在缓缓移动。
每十公尺定也可以
啊。OK， 好，好。
天。
Can you take a flare?
Okay. The west.
Whoa. 北极霸主终于现身，沿着海岸缓步走着。我们和他保持着距离，但似乎他也注意到了，有群人类正在。盯着他看。
哦，
他在看我。
对。他刚刚其实离我们很近。It looks like a male because male usually is much bigger than female. And so far as we saw, females usually with a little birds. So either was one baby, little ones, but actually every time was two.Mama with two,
oh,
shopping you. And the male usually walks alone. he's going directly to that place, so I think he's going for hunting.
Okay.
So, yeah, it would be actually nice to track it, but it's dangerous.
Okay.
So if he's in a hunting mood, we don't get close because, you know, it's dangerous.
So even though the distance is quite far away, we still have to be aware of this, right?
Oh, yes. I mean, he can sense us. And sometimes they might feel we can be their food and start to follow us. I mean, we have rifles, we have protection, so we are only safe enough to run back to the station. Mm-hmm. But of course, we could keep watching, because in 10 minutes he can change. If he starts running now towards us, we have to be really fast.
Yes.
He runs like 60 kilometers per hour or more.
Wow.
海滨是北极熊的栖地，但透过我们的镜头望去，夏天的北极海面上的浮冰稀稀落落，被迫踏上陆地的北极熊们身体慢慢出现了变化。加拿大科学家甚至预估，到了21世纪末，北极熊将永远消失。眼前这只公熊又还能撑多久呢？
From last 10 years, maybe the polar bears visit our station very often every summer, because they try to find new places of food.
Yes. No
places, it is a result of warming climate, because the food for polar bears I see is on the ice. They are looking for it, and they are very determination.
Yes. Yes.
The lighter, the younger.
年轻的小海豹看起来对这个世界还充满着好奇，对着我们的镜头各种摆拍，毫不怕生，却不知道什么时候可能就成了北极熊的丰盛大餐。
This is what we are also says. This is nature. This is not a zoo.
Yeah.
This is where we really see animals we have that. They are not afraid of people.We don't know that we can kill them, shoot them, but just watching us.
北极熊长期位居北极食物链的顶层，海豹是它们的主食。过去浮冰之下，丰富的浮游生物养活了小鱼小虾，吸引了鳕鱼觅食。这些鳕鱼就成了海豹和其他哺乳类的佳肴。但随着全球暖化，浮冰消失。原本因为身形庞大无法在冰下自在来去的杀人鲸，也开始进到了北极，成为猎食海豹的顶级掠食者。北极熊遇到了劲敌，觅食更难了。
But when you catch the tail, it usually gets only fat. Before the fat is the easiest digest. Then meat, you have to use a lot of energy to digest.And Beijing York is very smart with the balance, how much energy you spend to gain. So usually they only eat fat, but then the fox coming helps them.
途中我们看到了这副白骨，是北极熊饱餐一顿之后的海豹。大自然的食物链本该有它的运行法则，人类尝试用自以为的智慧主宰万物，却迎来反扑。而未来生态系统的崩溃，终究将冲击人类的生存。